Hello friends, this is Neha. Today in this video, we'll be discussing about splitting of d orbitals for various kind of geometry and some tricks related to that. The thing is that we know for octahedral complexes, the eg orbitals, that is dx square minus y square and dz square orbitals, are going to be higher in energy, and the t2g orbitals, that is dxy and dyz, dyz and dxz orbitals, are going to be lower energy. Then in case of tetrahedral complexes, for tetrahedral complexes we know that the scenario gets completely reversed. So these three are going to be now, they are going to have higher energy, and these two are going to have lower energy for tetrahedral complexes. And similar kind of diagram will be applicable for cubic also, for cubic geometry also. Then for tetragonal elongation, and for tetragonal elongation we have seen in Jahn-Teller distortion that what exactly happened means, look at this particular diagram. For elongation, what happens, this dz square, it gets stabilized, and dx square minus y square will have higher energy, and among these three the z component containing orbitals will have lower energy and dxy will have higher energy. So this is applicable for tetragonal elongation, and the same diagram is applicable for square pyramidal geometry also. Then we'll see for square planar. For square planar, what you have to do is just flip them. Like for example, send dxy over dz square over here, and others are same. Others are same. Just dxy will go up and dz square will go down. So this diagram will be for square planar complexes. Now next we'll see for trigonal bipyramidal and for pentagonal bipyramidal geometry. For both the geometries, what you have to do is the z component containing orbitals, that is dz square and dyz and dxz, you should arrange them on the extreme side, that z component containing orbitals. So dz square will have the highest energy, and these two are going to have the lowest energy, and the xy containing orbital should be lying, that is, in between. So this is applicable for the trigonal bipyramidal and for pentagonal bipyramidal geometry. Next, from this we can derive actually the splitting of d orbitals for different geometries. For example, if we want to derive the if we want to know the splitting of d orbitals for trigonal planar geometry, what you should do is you should remember first of all the splitting for TBP. So the thing is that just swap these two, that is, send the orbitals which are there on the second to 1, and the first which is there on the second. So that's why I have written 1 to 2. So that is applicable for trigonal planar. So this dx square minus y square and dxy will go up, and the dz square will come down, and the third one is as it is. The next one is for linear. For linear geometry, this how will be the splitting? The thing is that you have to swap these two, that is the second one and the third one. So these two are going to go up and this is going to be down. So dz square is constant, but these two are going to swap, and we'll get what? We'll get the splitting of d orbitals for linear geometry. Then the last one. That is for square antiprism. For square antiprism, you have to like interchange the third one and the first one, 3 and 1. So the thing is that these yz and xz will go up and dz square will come down, and the in between one is going to remain constant. So this is how the splitting of d orbital should be remembered for various geometries. Now let us solve the questions based on this particular thing. So in NET December 2011, a question was asked on it, that is, the correct order of d orbital splitting in trigonal bipyramidal geometries. So as I had told you, for trigonal bipyramidal, what you have to remember, the z component containing orbital should lie on the extreme. So extreme means, so the thing is that dz square is going to be on upper side, and yz and xz is going to be on the lower side, and the x containing orbital, that is if you see the dx square minus y square and dxy orbital, are going to lie in between. So what they are asking, the correct splitting. So the thing is that the highest energy is going to associate with what? With dz square, and then with dx square minus y square, and then the lowest energy will be with dyz and dxz, and the only option in which the dz square and dx square minus y square and these orbitals have got the energy is this one, and hence it is going to be the correct option. Next question was from like gate 2005, and in the trigonal, so which says in the trigonal bipyramidal crystal field, the d orbital with the highest energy, again TBP, the question on TBP was again asked, and it is asking the d orbital with the highest energy. So the d orbital with the highest energy, just now we have solved it on, so dz square is the answer, so d is going to be the answer. So just by remembering these splitting in d orbitals for various geometry with the trick that I have told, one can solve questions based on it. So that's all for this video. If